What's up, guys? This is Václav. I live in Czech Republic. I've spent last 2 years building and improving automation of this house using Home Assistant. I've done a couple of, I think, clever things. Controlling temperature, the boiler and the radiators, but also the shades on those large southern windows to keep the temperature fine in economical and ecological way. I'm controlling all the lights using different sensors. I'm also doing garden irrigation, obviously all the multimedia in the house. I have a bunch of sensors for different appliances, different variables, humidity, temperature, rain, things like the mailbox or doorbell signs. And I'm triggering some interesting stuff based on those sensors. Now, because I'm not selfish, I would like to share with you what I have done, but also show you how I did it, so you can do it after me if you like that. Now, about the temperature, I have a 12 years old boiler that is not possible to automate at all. It has equi-thermal regulation, it has a simple calendar where you can set fixed time schedule, like in the morning and in the evening it will run on a higher temperature and the other time it will lower temperature. And I wanted to adjust it based on the actual presence in the house, but the boiler has no API. But I managed to control it with an Arduino with a relay connected to the thermostat connector. So I changed the schedule based on the presence of the people in the house, the temperature and the time of the day. I have a 5 modes configured, the off, on, auto, then I have one echo, which is similar to auto but a bit more aggressive, and a vacation. When we leave the home, it will stop heating and it will recognize when we're coming back, so it will start heating again before we get home. In the evening, it will lower the temperature either based on the time or it will recognize that we are upstairs because we turn on the security system, and in the morning it will raise it again. Then there are the radiators. We used to have those old thermostats there. They did open and close the valve based on the ambient temperature, but they was constant. There were levels from 1 to 5, I think, but it was all the time the same, regardless whether the temperature in the house should be low or high. So we have replaced them by the thermostat controlled by the Z-Wave, and we set the target temperature to be consistent with the boiler as well. Then there is the sun. You have those large windows all across the southern side of the house. When it's sunny outside, it will heat up the interior very fast, much faster than the heating actually. So to overcome it, we have installed those external shades in all the windows and we tilt them to block the sun from coming in. Now, it's kind of stupid that we block the sun from coming in and to keep it nice and cold inside, and then we use the heating to heat it up, right? So if I could control the sun to help with the heating, that would be quite smart. And this is what I do. The problem was those shades were controlled manually. So what I have done is, again, I have installed a small Arduino in those wall boxes and I'm controlling the position and the tilt of those blades, and based on the temperature and other things, I am controlling temperature in the house to be optimal. And in the evening, I lower the shades to keep the heat in, but also to keep privacy inside because those windows are large. And in the morning, I just raise them up again. Then there is the lights. All the lights in the switches in the walls, there is either Sonoff or Shelly switch, so I can control the lights based on the movement sensors or based on different scenes or other automations. I built one recently that's when there is only one person in home, it recognizes, I call it single user mode, and what it does is it when someone comes into a bedroom and turns on the light, it will know that the person is in the bedroom, so it will turn off the lights in the rest of the house. Yes, I have kids, so that was a reaction on that, because I could see that most of the time when I'm not home, all the lights are on, so I'm controlling it in a smart way. All of those you can obviously turn off if it bothers you. I have a wife, she's not as crazy about automation, and that's why all the switches, if you come here, you wouldn't actually know that the house is automated. All the switches look exactly the same like they worked before. You toggle them on and off and they work fine, but you can also control them using Home Assistant. Then multimedia. I have two Google Homes, smart TV, a couple of speakers with the Chromecast, and I am streaming either radio stations or Spotify from within the Home Assistant. It's actually quite cool, and I can control it by voice from the Google Homes. And then there is all kinds of different sensors for the washing machine, dryer. Then I have one crazy sensor inside the mailbox. There's like an infrared sensor that will detect that there is something in. And when I come home and I will turn off the alarm, it will remind me that there is a mail in the mailbox, or indeed during a day, if we have a new mail, it will kindly remind us. Which is kind of cool. Before we had situations where we did have mail in the mailbox and I was assuming my wife would pick it up. She assumed the same. And it was there for a week. Rain sensor that I use for the garden irrigation. Then the garbage sensor. I made this one, so I hope you know it. If not, go and check it out. It's available on the community store. We obviously sort the garbage for paper, plastic, and so on. And we have like 5 or 6 different sensors for different types of waste. And it reminds us to take the trash out of the house. I have this little display next to the door that will show me when I'm leaving the house that I should take the trash out. On this display, I also show the current time and when the next bus is coming. I also wrote this little sensor for the Czech or Prague public transport. So if I want to know when is the next bus coming or leaving, I can just look at the display and it will tell me. There, by the way, also the mailbox icon there as well.
New man in the mailbox.
And then I check other things, like, I don't know, I have a sensor for the printer toner in this laser printer, right? Everything is coming into one place, into Home Assistant, so I have only one place to go to if I want to find out everything about this house. But I want to keep this video short, so I will end it here and I will make 4 other videos where I'm gonna go in detail into those things and show you how I done it. I will make 2 videos about the heating, about the thermostat and about the boiler. I'll show you how it's done. And then I'll make 2 about the shades of the house. And who knows, if you like that, I might continue with some others. All right, so that's it. See you next time.